Hi everyone, welcome back. As a teacher enrolled in a course, you have two options available for you to access the question bank. The first option is usually when you're in your course, you will have the three dots, and then you can click on question bank. This will direct you to the question bank, and here you can see if this is on questions, it will show you the questions. If this is on categories, it will show you the categories within the question bank. The other option available to access the question bank is through the quizzes. If you turn editing on, when you click on a quiz or when you create a quiz in your course, you will see in your quiz menu items there's the question bank. Here you can click on the question bank and it will also take you to the question bank. Here you can select categories and you'll see all the categories within the question bank. Notice that when you create a quiz, it also creates a default quiz question bank for you. So that's the two ways you can access the question bank, either through the course or through the quiz. Let's focus on setting up our categories and subcategories within our question bank. So let's head on over to our question bank. I'll click on the drop-down list here and choose categories. Now, I'll be setting up 5 modules within my course. So I'll name the main categories the module names. To add a category in your question bank, you'll click on Add Category. Make sure that you're in the correct parent category. This is usually the main category where you want to set up the categories. Now we can choose top for Moodle question bank, or we can choose the top for test, but we won't choose that. Or since I'm an administrator, I can also set up a question bank for my system. If I set up the question bank for my system, it will only be accessible to the administrators. So please make sure of that. Otherwise, you need to create a role that allow that particular role to access a question bank within this system, but more on that later on. So we will be using the top for Moodle question bank. Our first category will be our module name. So my first category will be module 1, Introduction to Moodle's Quiz Environment. I can provide a category information. I can also provide category ID number, but I'll leave that blank for now and I'll just click on Add Category. This will add the category. Now I can also rearrange the categories within the question bank. By hovering over the dot here, I can click, drag it to the top and it will be my top category. My second category will be my second module, so I'll click on Add Category. I'll make sure that it's in the correct parent category. I'll paste it in here or type it in here. I'll leave the category information blank as well as the ID number blank and I'll click on Add Category. So my second category is there, I'll just drag it up. So now I have two main categories. I'll add my third category. Click on Add Category and paste it in the name. Then I'll click on Add Category and that's my third one. I'll then create my fourth one. And then I'll create my last one. So now I have my 5 main categories. Now within each of the 5 categories, I want to create subcategories. So I'll have 2 quizzes within my main category. So in each of the main categories, I'll create those subcategories. To add a subcategory, all you need to do is click on Add Category. Make sure that the drop-down list, the parent category selected. So my parent category will then be module 1, since I will be creating a subcategory within module 1. I'll then add the name of my subcategory. So my name will be Quiz 1 and then Moodle Navigation and Basics. I'll leave the category information as well as the ID number blank, and I'll click on Add Category. Now you'll see it becomes indented and it's under Module 1. I'll now create my second subcategory. Click on Add Category. Make sure that my parent category is selected, and then I'll add my name of my subcategory. I'll click Add Category, and now my first category is created, subcategory created, my second subcategory is created. I will now continue the process for Module 2, Module 3, Module 4, and 5. If you've made a mistake and you want to change anything, you'll see the three ellipses here. You can click on it, and then you can either move it up or down. You can edit the settings. If you click on Edit Settings, you'll be presented with the same screen, and here you can make your modifications. If you've made a mistake by selecting it, by placing it on a different parent category, you can select a different category and place it there. The same for the subcategories. You can click on the ellipses. You can either move it, you can edit the settings, you can delete it, or you can export the question bank, the particular question bank or the subcategory. For Module 2, I'll click on Add Category. I'll make sure that it's on Module 2. I'll add the name, and then I'll click on Add Category. There you'll see it's added. I'll add the second one. Now you'll see I've added that, but it's now located at the bottom here. Why this happened? Because I didn't choose the correct parent category. Now I can click on the ellipsis icon. I can click on Edit Settings. I can then choose the correct parent category, and then I can click on Save Changes, and it will move that quiz or that subcategory in the correct main category or parent category. So let's do Module 3. I'll click on Add Category. I'll make sure that it's on Module 3. I'll paste the name of the category or the subcategory and add. So there's the first one and now the second one. And now let's do Module 4. Add a category. Make sure that it's in the correct parent. I'll paste it in there and click on Add. For the last one, I'll add my first subcategory, and then I'll add my second subcategory. And there we have our main categories as well as our subcategories. So I'm here in my question bank, and you'll see that we've created these subcategories and we've added questions to the subcategories. Now I want to add questions here, but I want to use questions from already created subcategories. So first I will export a subcategory, and then I will import it back into this particular categories. Now remember, these names can be changed, so this isn't set in stone, and I'll show you later on how to change these names. Now first we will export the second quiz, understanding quiz questions. Now to export questions in your question bank, at the top here you can click on the drop down list and click on export. It will then ask you the file format that you want to export it in. Now the safest file format is Moodle XML format. This is a format that if you want to import it back into Moodle, you can safely import it. There's also the Aiken format, the GIFT format, as well as the XHTML format. More on that later. So we select the Moodle XML format. We then scroll down and under the General tab, you'll see that Export category. It's currently set to Moodle, a default for Moodle Question Bank 101, 21 questions. So please make sure that you export the correct category. So I'll click on the drop-down list and I'll go to my Quiz 2 under Module 1. So I'll click that or select that. And now it asks me write category to file and write context to file. These two settings are really important, especially when you import it back into Moodle. So please make sure that you understand these two categories. Write category to file, which means is if I import it back to Moodle, it will write it to the same category. Write context to file, it will write it to the same context. Since this quiz is in module 1, it will write it in module 1 again. Okay, I'll explain it now when we import it. So if you're happy with this, export questions to file. And then you'll see it will export and it will show you that it downloaded to your downloads folder. If you click on the folder, you'll see that there's my questions that I've just exported. Let's go back to our question bank. So I'll click on the three dots, click to my question bank, and here I'm back in my question bank. I'll go to my categories. If I want to import that question, remember we've exported this. Now I want to import the questions. I'll click on categories again. I'll then click on import. And then I'll make sure that I select the Moodle XML format. Remember, we've exported into the Moodle XML format, so we'll import it the same way. If you scroll down under the General tab, you'll see Import Category, and it's currently set to Understanding Questions, Question Types. I'll select that, and then I'll select the category that I want to import those questions. Now, I want to import it in Module 5, Hands-on Practice. I want to import it in Mini Quiz Creation. So I'll select that. But now I want to make sure that it doesn't import it into the same category. So I'll deselect these two. Then it asks me, match the grades. Error if grade not listed. Okay, so it won't import if there's an error in the grade. You can also click on the drop-down list, nearest grade if not listed, but I'll usually leave it on this because then the import process will stop. Stop on error, yes. Then we need to upload our exported file or our questions that we've exported. I'll click on choose file. I'll then click on choose file again. So here is the questions that we've exported. I'll click on that and I'll click on open. And I'll then click on upload this file. It will show me the file that I've just uploaded and then I'll click on import. It will now give me a breakdown of the questions that I'm importing. You'll see that it shows me passing questions from file import, and then it shows me import for questions from file. If there is errors in your file, or if it's not compatible to what you've selected the file format, you will see the errors here. If you're happy with this, you click on continue. It will then add the files, the four questions, to that particular category. And let's go to that category. You'll see I didn't remove the files from there. It's still there, but I've exported and imported it back to this category here. So now you'll see the four questions there. I hope that makes sense. So it's the export and then the import. Now there's a huge difference between import and export and move. When you move questions, you remove it from the current category and you move it to a new category. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So if I want to remove this or move this questions back to another category. I'll click on that particular category. So I'll click on that. It will then provide me with a breakdown of the questions in that category. So here I see there's 4 questions. If I want to move these questions, I select them all, or I can select them one by one. So if I only want to move the 2 questions there, I can select them. But if I want to move all these questions, I can select all of them. I'll then scroll down and you'll see that it says here with selected. You can click on that. You can either delete it or you can move it. So let's click on move. Then I need to select the category where I want to move it to. So I'll click on the drop down list and I want to move it to the second quiz in module 5. So I'll select the second quiz. I'll then click on move to. Now let's see what happened. Go to categories. I'll go to module 5. You'll see in my first subcategory, there's now 0 questions. There's no questions because I've moved it to my second category. So that's the difference between import and import export and move. Move, you remove it from this category and you move it to a new category. So just keep that in mind. Moving is removing it from one category and moving it to a new one, but importing and exporting is adding to that particular category. Now that we have all our questions and our questions are nicely organized in our question bank, let's make some changes here in our question bank. So I don't want module 1, module 2, module 3. So I want to make changes to that. So how do I edit that? If you look at the name, next to the name, you'll see the 3 ellipses. You can click on that. And then you can either move it, edit it, delete it, or export as a Moodle XML question bank. So I want to edit it. So I'll click on edit. And then I'll change the name. I'll remove module 1 and I'll just leave the name there. I'll click on save changes. So there you'll see the module has been removed. I'll do the same for module 2. I'll click on edit. I'll remove that. And then I'll click on save changes. I'll scroll down and I'll do the same for module 3. Edit and remove. And then for the fourth one, I'll just do that again. I'll click on save changes. And then for the final one, I'll just click on edit settings and then remove that and then click save. So that's how easy it is to remove or edit the module names or the main categories. You can also do the same for the subcategories, but I'll leave that for now. So let's say you want to move them, you want to rearrange them. You can hover over the 6 dots here and you can click on it and move it up or down. This will move the whole section here. So the main category with the subcategories, you can move up and down. If you release it, it will end up in that section where you released it. You can also click on the ellipses and then click on move. This will appear. You will have to click on where you want to move it to. So let's say you want to move it to before module 3. You can click on that and it will move it to before module 3 or module 4. Or you can do the same for the below here. You just need to specify. I'll leave it as is, but that's a possibility. You can also move within the subcategories. So if you want to move quiz 1 to where quiz 2 is, you just drag and drop them. Or you can select the ellipses and click on move, and you can move it the same way you move the main category.